spin me around. People get used to and bookmark sites like VidMe, VID.me, VidMe. Bookmark that site, folks, because YouTube may soon go completely vanilla on you.
Facts, 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 facts. He is listening to you, so speak directly to the president. Go ahead.
Oh, my God. Well, hello, President Trump. You said I should live another 25 years when you put your arm around me at Mar-a-Lago. I hope you mean it, because I can use another 25 minutes the way I feel. My feeling is this. Tillerson is misleading you. I have no idea why people don't see through that man. It seems to me that it's so plain that you don't have to be a genius to see what happened here. What does ExxonMobil gain if they cut Syria out of the gas lines that are running out of the Middle East to Europe? What does ExxonMobil gain by that, Alex? That's the whole story in a nutshell. It's another war for oil. It's all over again. It's the same thing as 1999. Remember when Bill Clinton was mercilessly bombing the Serbian people?
Yes. For the Muslims.
I wrote an article. In 1999, the oily tracks run through Kosovo. It was a little-noticed article. My heart was broken because Bill Clinton engaged in 78 of the worst days of my life until now.
Michael Savage turns on Trump, says Syrian gas attack was false flag. I don't think it's turning on Trump. It's warning Trump. Maybe I'm wrong, but CNN saying he's turned on Trump. I don't want to put words in his mouth. I haven't gotten his total view on this, but Dr. Savage of MichaelSavage.com, am I wrong to say you haven't turned? You're desperate.
Trump, that's the vermin in the left trying to divide and conquer once again. It's the garbage of the world in the media.
Absolutely.
The trash, the filth. The sludge. I never turned on Trump. Now, I don't know whether we can reach Trump. That's the problem. What I'm afraid of is, Alex, I could go on for another hour, which I will do when I'm on my own show, but World War II is very telling. We all hear that Japan attacked Pearl Harbor precipitously and without warning, that it was a sneak attack. People don't know the prelude to that. Japan had been starved for natural resources.
Cutting off their oil.
Cut off their oil. Pushed them up against the wall. They had been our ally before that. Now what do we want to do now? Turn Russia into our greatest enemy once we hit them with more sanctions and cut off their revenue source from oil?
When they're reforming.
Well, what do you think Russia's going to do, for God's sakes?
That's why the left is so angry. They're now a Christian nation. I hate it. In closing, since you said it, because you're an astute guy, obviously, Michael Savage, Dr. Michael Savage, MichaelSavage.com, joining us. Let me ask you this question. What is it that happened last week? I know his daughter and others did come and put pressure on him. They said, you know, you've got to do this to show you're strong. I think Tillerson and others have kind of backed off the day off war drums. So I think what you're saying and others are saying is having an effect. But what do you think it was happened a week ago, Dr. Savage?
Oh, goodness, you're asking me. I don't know. I wasn't there. The president is a good-hearted man. That's the problem. I'm a soft-hearted man and a good-hearted man. So you show me a picture of two babies or three babies who were dead. Of course I'm going to have compassion for them. But now you connect it to someone who didn't do it, you might hit the wrong target. So before we act again, for God's sakes, let's look at the pictures all over again. Who did it? We don't know who done it. You know, I was the first one in the media to say it didn't look like sarin gas. I do have a PhD, by the way, partly in epidemiology from one of the great universities. A real doctor, and I'm the only one in the radio business who has any background in science.
That's right. Speak to that. I don't have degrees like you do, and medical degrees, but you're right. I mean,
but it does come in handy when you're dealing with science illiterates in the media who don't even put two and two together. I was the first one to say, for God's sakes, wait a minute, all of these people, the first responders, are there without gloves, some of them in sandals, and it's supposed to be a sarin gas attack? They would be dead within minutes. That's number one. Number two, it didn't look like it was sarin gas. It did not look like a nerve agent. It looked like a chlorine-based agent, which doesn't make it any less ugly. But that means the whole story is a lie. From top to bottom, one last point, and I know we both have to go. On my show today, I have both Pat Buchanan, who is brilliant, agrees with us. I also have another man who agrees with us, who was one of the chief, his name is Lawrence Wilkerson. No one ever heard of him.
I've heard of him.
United States Army colonel. But he was chief of staff to Colin Powell. during the 2003 false flag invasion of Iraq.
The fake anthrax reports.
Thank you. Wilkerson says this is another repeat of Iraq all over again. The same exact story.
Oh, Michael, we got 30 seconds left, but they already have ground troops on the ground in Syria. The media then says that's a conspiracy theory, even though a month ago they admitted Marines, artillery, army. This is crazy. In 20 seconds, closing comment, Michael Savage.
I pray for Donald Trump. He's our only chance. It's why we all work so hard for him. I pray to God he understands that we're all fighting the same war as he is. But his greatest war right now is a war for the truth. And I hope to God if he hears this message, Alex, he will listen to Alex Jones and Michael Savage to stop the war before it gets worse.
He is doing your live in 30 minutes at michaelsavage.com and stations across the country. Michael, let me say bye to you in the break. I know you have the flu. Thank you for the exclusive. We'll be back with calls straight ahead. Stay with us.
Thank you very much. We're not taking any questions. Goodbye.